power in action, action for Christ. Pope Francis, in addressing the youth at the 2019 World Youth Day, opined that the youth are the future leaders of the church, and that is true. But as I look at the color youth of today, so many questions come to mind. Can this generation hand over the Catholic Church to the youth of today for the next generation? When I look at the youth of today, so many questions come to mind. When we go for morning mass, our youth are not there. The sacrament of penance, the youth are not there. When it's time for the Holy Communion, the youth are not there. Where are our youth? Look as if our youth, unfortunately, have lost appetite for the Catholic spirituality. Rather, our youth have serious appetite for Pentecostalism, sensationalism, and charismatic spirituality. Can the church hand over the mantle of leadership to our youth of today? Are the youth ready to preserve and maintain the authentic Catholic teachings? Are they ready and are they prepared to hold the mantle of the church in the next generation? Will they maintain the Catholic identity? I mean the undiluted and authentic faith handed down by the apostles. If saints like St. Padre Pio, St. John Paul, St. Augustine, and St. Jerome should come back to life, will they be surprised at the kind of Catholicism we are practicing? Or they'll be shocked by the ungathered syncretism and dilution that has paved its way in our Catholicism, especially in our part of the world? The Catholic youth of our time is confronted with so many challenges and problems. The youth of our time have little or no knowledge of the Catholic faith. Yes, indeed, our youth of today prefer spiritual powers without holiness. Our youth prefer to put pictures, banners, and stickers of other pastors rather than own bishops and saints. Indeed, our youth prefer going for prayer meeting than going for mass. Is the future promising? Say that our youth are prepared for the next generation. When our youth believe in prophecies than the Bible and the authentic teachings from the Magisterium, is our future promising? When our youth, will they maintain the Catholic identity? Is the future promising? When our youth have strong appetite for Pentecostal spirituality than the authentic Catholic spirituality? René Descartes was therefore right when he said, "I think, therefore I am." There is something seriously wrong with the thinking and mindset of our youth of today. Do we really know our identity as Catholics? What is our branding as Catholic youth? What makes us unique as Catholics? Do we really appreciate and embrace the sacrament? Is the sacrament really relevant to the lives of the youth of today? Oh, who is to blame? Some say it's the clergy, some say it's the laity. Or perhaps the dogmas and teaching of the church are not enough. But I have no doubt in mind that the Catholic Church has so many dogmas enough for authentic spirituality and human development. Oh, who is to blame? I do not know, but what I do know is that we must all rise and build. Yes, let us all rise and build, because we have a duty. Our duty is to hand over the Catholic for the next generation as we came to meet it. Let us preserve, let us defend, let us maintain the authentic teaching of the Catholic Church. Be proud as a Catholic, be bold, be confident. Let us rise and build. Yes, we can. Yes, we must. Yes, we will. And let us all come together and build the church. Arise, Catholic youth. Let us all rise and build the Catholic Church. This message is from the village preacher. God bless you.